Hi guys, I hope you're all ready for lesson 15. Like I said before, we will learn the times of day, and in this lesson we're going to do exactly that. We're also going to look at some expressions and then some prepositions of movement as well. So are you ready? First, let's go ahead and review some of the times of day, okay? Now, the first time of day is morning. Now, remember, when we have AM, that usually represents morning, okay? AM is the morning. And when you wanna say hello to somebody, oftentimes in the morning you can say, good morning, right? When you say hello, like good morning, right? Good morning. But when you wanna say goodbye to somebody or bid somebody farewell, you say, have a good morning, okay? Goodbye, have a good morning, see you later. So good morning is to say hi. And when you want to say goodbye, you say have a, and then good morning. Okay? So have a good morning when you want to say goodbye. Next we have afternoon, and remember afternoon is also the PM. We use PM for the afternoon. Afternoon is usually, so guys, morning is usually from, I don't know, you know, morning would be like 6 a.m. until, 11:59 a.m. Okay, and then afternoon starts at 12 and goes till about 5 p.m. Okay, and when you want to say hello to somebody, you can say good afternoon, right? So you go to a restaurant and they say, hi sir, good afternoon. Okay, hello, good afternoon. Again, when you want to say goodbye, you say have a and then good afternoon. Goodbye, have a good afternoon, thank you for coming, right? Next you have evening, and evening usually is from 5 to about 8 o'clock, 8 or 9 maybe, 8 or 9, evening. Also this is the PM, okay, so PM is also evening. You could say good evening, right? Good evening, how are you? Hi, good evening. And then also to say goodbye, you say have a good evening, okay? That's it. Things are a little bit different with night, okay? So night we use for AM, okay? So it's usually AM in that case would be from 12 AM until about 6 AM, okay? 6 AM, that can be night, but night can also be from 9 to 12, okay? So it can be 9 PM, 10 PM, 11 PM, etc. Okay, so we'll put 9 p.m. to 12 a.m. Okay, so night can be a.m. or p.m. Okay, and remember here how when you want to say hello to somebody, you say good morning, or for the afternoon, you say good afternoon, or for the evening, you say good evening. Like, hi, how are you? Good evening, thank you. For night, you don't do that, okay? For night, you have to say good evening or just hello or hi or something. You cannot say good night. Okay, we only say good night when you want to say goodbye. Okay, so good night meaning goodbye, thank you for coming, good night. Or you could just say night, simple, fast, night. Or you could say again, have a good night, right? Goodbye, have a good night. Okay, so pretty easy. Just remember, night is a little bit different, okay? You cannot say, hi, good night, right? It doesn't sound good. You only use night for goodbye situations, okay? Then we have some other words here. Midnight, for example. You know what time midnight is? Midnight is at 12 a.m., okay? So when it's 12 a.m., that's midnight. Noon. Okay, so noon is at 12 p.m., so I'll put 12 a.m. here, 12 a.m., this is 12 p.m. Dawn, do you know when dawn is? Dawn is when the sun comes up in the morning, okay? We call it dawn, right? Dawn is when the sun comes up, and what do you think dusk is? What is dusk? Dusk is the opposite of dawn. Dusk is when the sun goes down. So you have dawn and dusk. You have midnight and noon, okay? Now I wanna show you some new verbs that you can use for different times of the day with things that you do for your daily routine. The first one that we're gonna learn is to get up, okay? So to get up in the morning. You're sleeping in your bed and you get up and you say good morning, right? Good morning, mom. Good morning, dad. Good morning to whoever you talk to. Good morning to your friends or whoever, but you get up. Another way you could say this is to wake up, okay? So to get up and to wake up are pretty similar when you do it in the morning, okay? You do that in the morning, and then we have to go to bed or to go to sleep, okay? So you do that at night, okay, in the evening during the PM. So you get up and you wake up in the morning, and then you go to school or you go to work, and then you come home and you go to bed or you go to sleep. Okay, so these are some verbs that you can use to talk about times of the day, what you do during the day, okay, part of your daily routine. So now we're going to look at some sentences, but I want to tell you first what prepositions to use before each of the words and explain a little bit about prepositions of movement. So you're going to see here we have prepositions of movement, and then we have these. Now, when we talk about prepositions of movement, you can see here that we have in the and then blank. Okay, so when we have in the, we're going to take one of these words. Okay, so in the, let's say morning. In the morning. And then we have in the afternoon, right? So in the afternoon. So afternoon. And then finally, you could say in the evening. Evening. Okay, evening. Now when you have at here, you have to, you can't say at morning, at afternoon, at evening. You have to say at, and you can say at night right here, at night. So we'll put night, N-I-G-H-T. You could say as well, you could say at midnight. Okay, midnight. Or you could say at noon, right? So noon, N-O-O-N. At dawn, D-A-W-N. And finally, at dusk, okay, when the sun goes down. Remember, dawn is when the sun comes up, dusk is when the sun goes down. So in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, at night, at midnight, at noon, at dawn, and then at dusk. Okay, so pretty easy for you to remember. Now let's go ahead and look at prepositions of movement. Prepositions of movement are words like along, which means like along something. You have a line here and it's along a river or along a lake, along the beach, along the house. Okay, for example, along the whiteboard. Okay, along the whiteboard. My hand goes along the whiteboard. Okay, across, okay, so across means on the upper other side. So this is the left side of the board, and then across is the right side of the board. So left, right, across. Then we have up, right, up. Then you have down, down. You have into, like into something, into a house, into a university, into a place. Okay, you have out of when something comes out. So for example, you have a box of popcorn, okay, and you put your hand in the box of popcorn and you pull out popcorn, right? You pull out. So out of, over, like over your head, and then through, okay, through, right? Right through the city, right through the body, right through something. Okay, so again, along, across, up, down, into, out of, over, and through. Now, when we talk about prepositions of movement, we're going to use these with the times of day and expressions. So let's begin with number one. Are you ready? What do you do in the morning? And then it says, in the morning, I get up at 6 a.m. and go running along the river. So here you could see that we have morning to talk about the time of the day, and then we have along, which is a preposition of movement. Number two, where do they go in the afternoon? They go out of town to visit their family. So let's say they live in any town. They live in
I don't know, let's say they live in Los Angeles or they live in New York City. They go out of New York City and they go to Boston to visit their family. So they're not in New York City. They are out of New York City. You understand? So where did they go in the afternoon? They go out of town to visit their family in the afternoon. Where do you drive at night? Driving like a car, okay, or a motorcycle maybe. Where do you drive at night? I drive into the city at night. Into. Where does this, when? So like, at what time? When does the sun come up? The sun comes up at dawn. Remember, we have midnight, noon, dawn, and dusk. Dawn is when the sun comes up. Number five, where do the clouds float at midnight? So you look up in the sky, what do the clouds do? They float across the sky. So where do the clouds float at midnight? The clouds float across the sky at midnight. Okay, so pretty easy, guys. Before we end this lesson, I also want to talk to you a little bit about some additional verbs. For example, when we're remembering time phrases, generally they come at the end of sentences, unless you really want to stress the time of day, okay? In which case, you would put the time phrase at the beginning of whatever sentence you have, okay? Moreover, the preposition of movement must come after the verb of motion, okay? So a verb of motion is a verb such as to go, okay, or to walk, or to run, or to swim, or to fly, like a bird, to fly, okay? It's a verb that takes you from one place to another place, from point A to point B, okay? So anyways, guys, I think that's it for this lesson on times of the day and expressions and then prepositions of movement. I think that's going to be it for this lesson, lesson 15. I want to thank you once again for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye, guys. See ya.